Ridgeline Land Planning Incorporated, ZA3667. Ms. Goldman.
This is a request to rezone from Agricultural District A1 and Single Family Residential District Res 3 to Single Family Residential District Res 3 on 21.74 acres for 38 residential lots with a density of 1.75 units per acre. This property is located at 945 and 951 Settles Road in 1680 and 1688 Thunder Gulch Pass, Suwanee, Georgia 30024. Staff is supportive.
Thank you. I make a motion to open the public hearing for Ridgeline Land Planning Incorporated, ZA3667. May I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Iglesias. Is there any discussion? All in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Motion to open the public hearing passes 5-0. Is there anyone wishing to speak in favor of Ridgeline Land Planning Incorporated, ZA3667?
Madam Chair, Emory Lipscomb here on behalf of Ridgeline Land Planning, Inc. In ZA3667, this is a request for a Res 3 from Settles Road. Originally, we requested 43 lots on this zoning. That would have been a density of 1.97 homes per acre with a 10,000 square foot lot minimum and a 2,000 square foot minimum house size with no zoning buffer. We had a revision of that later where we reduced the number of lots from 43 to 38, which reduced the overall density to 1.75, basically 1.748 units per acre. That also would have had a 10,000 square foot lot minimum and 2,000 square foot minimum house size. But more recently, met with the neighborhood and agreed to a revision from the 38 lots, the original 43 lots, down to 32 lots, which produces a density of 1.47 homes per acre. We've increased the square footage of minimum for a lot to 12,500 square feet with an overall average of 16,000 square feet in a lot. And we've increased the lot size from 2,000 square foot minimum to 3,200 square foot minimum. We've agreed that all of the homes would have basements except for two of the homes which might not have basements. Those would be the first two going into the subdivision. We've agreed to a 25-foot buffer on the lots adjacent to Grand Cascades, and we've agreed that the homes would be three sides of brick, stone, stucco, and we're now hoping that this would be a gated community, so that is an option that we're asking for, to have the option to have a gated community. That we've had some very cooperative meetings with the neighbors in Grand Cascades and other of the neighborhoods there. I want to thank those folks for their cooperation and help in dealing with these issues. We've also been aware and met with another group from Grand Cascades, which has been doing extensive work on their ponds and stormwater management for the ponds and for the drainage area which runs into those ponds, and we're cooperating with those folks because some of the water passes through the property which is the subject of this rezoning prior to it reaching those ponds. So so they have an interest, and we do too, in making sure that, that the siltation sediment is contained as required to be under the laws of the state of Georgia and ordinance of this county. This proposed zoning conforms to the future land use map, future development map, as it's called now, and the comprehensive plan. The staff is supportive of the zoning. We're glad to answer any questions.
Thank you. Is there anyone else wishing to speak in support of ZA3667? Is there anyone wishing to speak in opposition to ZA3667? Mr. Meadows, did you fill your form out?
I did, ma'am.
If you'll state your name first.
My name is Jeff Meadows, resident of Grand Cascades, and Jason. Question. This is PowerPoint. Hey, my name is Jeff Meadows. I live in Grand Cascades. I want to thank the Board of Commissioners, the Planning Commissioners, everyone has been very available, very helpful, as has the county staff. I also want to thank our community, as you see behind us. They've been very supportive and very active. Regarding where we're at, we have had some two very good meetings with Emory, Brett, the developer, and Holt, the applicant. We were very excited about the first meeting we had, and I will say courage, not excited, by what we heard. Now, we proactively reached out to Emory and the applicant in an effort to try to come to an agreement. They were receptive, if you want to note that. But as of the last meeting, they stated very, very clearly that the lots adjacent to Grand Cascade lots, which are 33,000 square feet to 25,500 square feet around that area, we're going to be 12,500 square feet. That's just not acceptable. On that point alone, we're going to ask for this to be denied. The other points that we saw on the plat was that on some of the adjacent lots to Grand Cascades, there were up to three lots in development. So there'd be three lots per one plat. Again, we can't accept that at this point in time. So we ask, again, this be denied. We had over 200 folks at our first meeting in January. We had Lambeth High School graduation today, and dinners, parties, etc. tonight. So our numbers are down quite a bit, but I still want to thank our community for their support and participation. From the beginning, our compromise proposal to the developer applicant, Emory, was 18,500 square foot lots, which is Res 2. That's based upon the fact, again, that the adjacent lots in Grand Cascades are 33,000 to 25,000 square feet. Lots within the neighborhood are just as large as that. The southern part of the neighborhood has lots even larger than that. We are asking for lot widths the same width as the adjacent lots currently there, and that was suggested to us by a Board of Commissioners member in District 2. Because he said that had worked well in previous zoning, recent zones. We asked for a 50-foot undisturbed buffer. Again, it could be a combination of a disturbed buffer that would be replanted and hopefully undisturbed buffer. We asked that the easements in the Baker property be legally abandoned because we do not want a through road being built from Champions Run or any other adjacent property to Settles Road. And of course, we asked for protection of our lakes, streams of Grand Cascades, and also on the property itself. So with that, we need to ask for you folks to consider denying this request. And Ms. Shaw would like to speak next.
Thank you, Mr. Meadows.
Thank you.
Ms. Shaw, did you turn your...
I did.
Thank you. State your name first, please.
My name is Liz Shaw, and I'm a resident of Grand Cascades subdivision. I would like, first of all, to slide to the screen.
There you go.
I would like to first of all to draw your attention to a number of points in the Forsyth County Comprehensive Plan which relate to the property under discussion and to clarify why we are asking for Res 2 zoning. The map clearly shows that there are two character areas, the upper portion being Baker property is in the blue area, which is the suburban living character area, whereas the remaining a much larger portion is in the river residential character area, below that, the green area. I want to focus on river residential, as the property is mainly in that designation. Typically, this area is characterized by lower housing densities, larger lots, stream buffers, and natural areas. In fact, this is exactly what you see when you drive down Settles Road and pass existing homes and the Settles Cove, Cascade Run, and Grass Run Cascade subdivision. A very distinctive character area, very distinctive from suburban living. The zoning map, which follows, clearly shows that R2R, which is on either side of the subject property, and Res 2, which is the Grand Cascade subdivision to the south, are the predominant adjacent zonings. There is Res 3 zoning to the north, surrounding the Baker property. That, however, is buffered from Champions Run by the stream and the associated buffers. This slide, I think, really points to the concern that we have. The property is infill development. So we feel that it's really important that it should be compatible with the existing developments, as stated in the comprehensive plan and section 8-5.5 subsection F of the Unified Development Code. This slide clearly indicates actual adjacent lot sizes which range from a minimum of 20,000 square feet to more than 50,000 square feet. A larger view of the Greater Settles Road area shows the major streams and the stream and the lakes into which the subject property drains. And this is a great concern as other developments along this stream corridor have already caused major sediment issues in the downstream lakes. I want now just to go back to the comprehensive plan with my next slide. The text in black highlights the most relevant and critical development strategies. The first being to encourage new residential development to blend with existing housing through appropriate open space and buffering requirements. And I'm not going to take the time reading the rest of them, but I do want to make a point under the development guidelines for river residential that new residential development must, and I emphasize, must respect the scale and character of adjacent residential neighborhoods. Let me go to my conclusion. So in conclusion, this is why we are, these points are why we are asking or feel that we have no alternative but to ask for a Res 2 zoning and denial of the Res 3 request. Because the larger lots would be more compatible. We're asking for appropriate buffering, closure of the access easement to Thunder Gulch, and no negative water runoff and sedimentation impacts to the adjacent properties. And I realize that some of these points have been addressed, but the compatible lot sizes is the one area that we have not come to agreement. In the end, we all want the highest and best use as an outcome in the best interests of the property owners and the surrounding community. The process is still not finalized, and we are respectfully asking for your consideration of our request to deny the application for Res 3 zoning. Thank you.
Thank you, Michelle. Is there anyone else wishing to speak in opposition? You have 1 minute and 42 seconds.
This is Craig Cline from the HOA. I'm secretary of the HOA. I will probably need the mask for the community to do an extension of time, because I'll probably need about 2 or 3 minutes for the time that I'll get into it there and now.
2 or 3 minutes total?
3 minutes total.
3 minutes total. Why don't we go ahead and extend this 2 more minutes? I make a motion to extend the time 2 more minutes so that we have 3 minutes and 23 seconds. Seconded by Commissioner Dolezal. Is there any discussion? All those in favor of the motion to extend the time, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion passes 5-0.
Thank you very much. I do appreciate that. Again, my name is Greg Cline. I'm Secretary of the Frankfurt State Homeowners Association, and I'm authorized by the HOA Board to speak before you here. And I want to echo everything that Mr. Meadows said in his group. He's fully supportive of that, and I think all those points are well taken. I'm addressing one very specific issue dealing with the sedimentation and environmental impact of this proposed development. And I just want to very briefly talk about Grand Cascades history right now, because it's very significant to the entire issue. Grand Cascades has been wrestling with this issue of sedimentation in the last 2 or 3 years. This has all been caused by upstream development, dump sediment into our lakes. Time and time again, we've seen this. It's happening now, and it's happened in the past. This affects not only the residents of Grand Cascades, because it causes the loss of the lake area, which turns into wetlands, but also our lakes feed into the Chattahoochee. This affects everyone downstream, millions of people. Sedimentation going there is a significant issue. Because of the seriousness of this issue, Grand Cascades has made the extraordinary step of hiring Schnabel Engineering almost 3 years ago at a significant cost, which I think is pretty extraordinary for anyone to do, in a subdivision. We asked them to study the issue, report back to the HOA, craft solutions to the issue, and oversee the sedimentation removal and dam repair. We are now at the stage where we're implementing corrective measures. We're all excited about that. Then this development comes on, ZA3667. Naturally, we were very interested in what was happening. So we engaged Schnabel Engineering to look into this, to see what impact this additional development would have onto our issue. And the reason it's significant was that Schnabel confirmed the entire ZA3667 property was in the watershed, all of it's in the watershed of our upper lake. So we actively engaged the developer, Ridgeline, and also Emory about this, and to seek information so that Schnabel could make an evaluation. They asked for two very specific things. One was their stormwater management plan, and number two, very modest request of allowing Chuck Wilson, the engineer of Schnabel, to walk the property and to take samples from a handoff. Now, the developer was forthcoming with some of these issues. However, they refused to allow him to take soil samples, which is critical. We're very disappointed. We also find that this is very ironic that the property owners are not allowing us to take soil samples. But 2 weeks before our request, they had heavy equipment doing soil samples. And the reason they say they won't let us do it is they don't want the land disturbed. So here's what we're asking. We're aware that they made two changes very late. We got them about 2 hours before this hearing. One, we definitely want Schnabel to be able to take soil samples and conduct their study so that we know the extent of the problem. And we ask that this be this request be deferred until Schnabel has been able to take those soil samples and do the report. Or alternatively, have the county do a water report, which is happening up in Champions Run.
Madam Chair, this time.
I just have 1 more minute.
1 more minute.
It still says 123.
It's wrong. Justin is trying to keep up with it by hand. It quit working again. What's the pleasure of the board?
If he's finishing this point, I'd like to know.
Okay. 37.
We'll vote. I'll make a motion to extend the time one more minute. May I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Iglesias. Is there any discussion on that? All in favor of the motion to extend the time one more minute, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Motion to extend the time one more minute passes 5-0. Okay.
Thank you. So we want to defer, we would ask to defer this until Shawville or the county has conducted a proper hydrological survey so we know the extended sedimentation runoff that will happen with this development. Number one, that's not addressed in the change orders. Number two, we also want a firm commitment from the developer that they will provide remediation for sedimentation that is dumped into our lakes, which we feel will surely happen. And that could take a little financial compensation so that we can pay for the sediment removal that will be removed from our lakes. And with those two qualifications, we very much like to see. I want to thank you for your time and your considerations.
Thank you, Mr.
Clark.
We have
1 minute. You have 18 seconds left.
18 seconds left. Is there anyone who wishes to speak in opposition for 18 seconds?
And there's a gentleman right here.
Jack Lee's number is Harcrow. I'm the environmental compliance officer. I walked the property. It was not posted, no trespassing. Beautiful property. It's got a lot more water on it than they depicted on the drawing. So I encourage you to, whatever buffers you do, undisturbed buffers, to clarify that they're undisturbed. And I would strongly encourage you to have an independent party walk the property for city walks, as there are extensive.
It's time, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Gleason.
Madam Chair, just wanted to let you know that we do have at least one other gentleman who wishes to speak in opposition, just for your, the board's information.
No, it's not in opposition. Yes.
Just 1 minute, sir, and let us see if we can extend some time. I make a motion to extend the time one more minute. Seconded by Commissioner Dolezal. All in favor to extend the time one more minute, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion passes 5-0. Sir, did you fill a form out?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and would you state your name?
My name is Phillip Baker.
Thank you.
We are selling the property to Ridgeline, and some of the statements that have been made tonight based on not being allowed to get on the property. There was almost a month ago that documents were signed for their engineers to come in and inspect the property. They have stalled in doing that. Now, I understand Grant Cascade's concern about the settlement. I've been dealing with it for the last over 10 years now, that when Rockland it was Windmark, but Champion Glen Subdivision, and have dealt with it for many years. Now, I did go down to Snoddle and looked at what they had suggested to Champion Glen. And the fact is...
Now, I'm sure that's time.
The fact is, they have...
Do you think that if we gave you one more minute, you could complete this?
Yes.
Speaking of things, we have a rebuttal.
Yes, but we have time for a rebuttal.
That's fine.
Oh, wait, just 1 minute. Let's see what happens.
We will, I believe it is appropriate to consider it as rebuttal time. There was time.
5 minutes.
Yeah. 5.2 plus actually 3 additional minutes that were extended.
Okay, so.
So there, we're, that leaves us with 7 minutes and 22 seconds.
Okay, so I make a motion to extend the time one more minute.
I don't believe it's necessary to consider this.
Oh, it's not?
Since he's the speaking in favor.
Okay, this is rebuttal. I get it now. Sorry. I'm sorry.
And then that probably was my fault for coming out of position. I misunderstood him when he indicated he was still wishing to speak.
Okay. All right. You're fine. I'm sorry that I had to interrupt. All right. Now, go ahead.
However, having gone down to Snoddle, who the engineering company is that ran Cascade Hire, they have found that because the landowners around the lakes created their property line right to the lake, they have added to the silt and everything that's right on there. And they are requesting, and I think there is a permit that they have requested in order to have dredging done around the lakes. Now, I agree that Grand Cascades and the development by originally Windmark owners and then Rockland owners has created this. However, the pond that I have had for over 30 years has collected a lot of this silt. And they are protected because of our pond and the pond below us before it gets to Grand Cascades. And there are two lakes down there. If they would actually go back and look, they would find that they have created part of the problem themselves. And we have blocked it and it getting down to them. You're more than welcome to come out and look and see that our pond is almost 3/4 full of silt that has come from the development. So this complaint with them about the water, I agree with them. I have dealt with it for many, many years. However, my wife and I are at an age that we're ready to move on. And I think this will be a good development for the county. If y'all would look at that and see that the homes are larger than in Grand Cascade, and the only reason that the size of the lots are smaller is because this is going to have sewage. They have septic tanks. And that is something that they're not willing to discuss open and honestly with the board. That's all I've got to say.
Thank you, Mr. Baker. So now, does Mr. Lipscomb have time as well?
Yes, and I'm doing the math.
You're doing the math. Our timer is acting up, so we're having to do this by hand.
I showed 6 minutes and 26 seconds. There was 5 minutes and 42 seconds. 3 additional minutes were added. He spoke for 2 minutes and 16 seconds, leaving total 6:26.
For Mr. Lipscomb to rebuttal?
Yes.
Or whoever. Would you like to have your say?
Yes, thank you. You know, I think that some of the things that have been said here have been rebutted in part by what Phil said. The lots that were shown as being much larger lots are served for wastewater purposes with septic tanks rather than sewer. This is going to be on sewer, this property is. Mr. Gleason said that we should have, the county should have someone to go on to the property and determine whether the waters of the state have been correctly shown, and that has been done, and the person who is designated for making that determination has been on the property and has determined that they are correctly shown. So that has been done. The concern about the road that came down from the north not being allowed to be a through road, that concern is one of ours also, and we have asked and we have agreed that that not be allowed to continue. So that is not an issue. We're in full support of terminating that road. We are cooperating with both the Jeff Meadows, Liz Shaw group, and Greg Cline's group. It's taking longer than and all of us would like for some of that work to get done, but we are continuing to cooperate and will through the Board of Commissioners meeting. We have the same desire that they do, and that is to make sure that this development fits the area. We submit to you that it will, the price of homes and the gating of the community will reflect very favorably on that area down there. The road improvements recommended by the engineering department will be made, making that a safer area there. I think that covers the points that I wanted to make.
Thank you. I make a motion to close the public hearing for Ridgeline Land Planning Incorporated, ZA3667. May I have a second? Seconded by Commissioner Iglesias. Is there any discussion? All in favor of the motion to close the public hearing, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Motion to close the public hearing passes 5-0. The board can ask questions now if they choose to. Does anybody have any questions about anything?
Wait,
before you do that, I need to ask staff something. We've had a commissioner exit the room for a short period of time. Do we need to not continue or?
If you were finished with the public hearing and there's no further testimony provided, you could proceed. If Commissioner Hoyt sounded like he might have some relevant questions, the question and response should be the commissioner present.
Okay.
Or preferably would be if she's short.
So should we just like take a 5-minute recess or a 3-minute recess or?
A recess until Commissioner Mills returns I don't know what else.
I make a motion to recess the meeting until Commissioner Mills returns. I really don't think it'll be but a couple of minutes, so please don't everybody get up and run off. May I have a second?
Second.
That motion is seconded by Commissioner Dolezal to take a
sorry. I was getting your business card to contact me.
Oh, well, thank you.
Okay, never mind. We're going to withdraw the motion and withdraw the second and carry on. That's okay. Commissioner Hoyt, now I believe you do have some questions, correct?
Yes.
I got the business card.
First one is about stormwater, and I believe Mr. Cline was talking about this, but also Mr. Gleason and Mr. Baker too, I guess. But as I'm understanding it and looking at the diagram, there's a stream that comes down from the property to the west that passes through this property on its way through ponds and into the lake at the bottom of the hill. And as I understand it, the grading that would be done in this proposed subdivision hadn't been done yet. So does anybody have any information about where all the sediment that's in the ponds now comes from? Because I've heard expressed a fear that there's going to be a lot more. And I think Mr. Cline mentioned something about liability of somebody to somebody, and I don't know that that's part of our bailiwick if people get into wanting financial compensation from each other. But I would like to hear what the situation now is with sediment and the source of it, if anybody knows.
So is Mr. Cline who you would like to answer?
Well, Mr. Cline or any of the people who spoke to him, but Mr. Cline first, if possible.
Mr. Cline, could you come forward, please?
I would be interested in hearing if Schnabel could actually address that in there.
Yes.
What the current cause was.
Yes, so maybe somebody from the applicant can tell us that.
And state your name again.
Yeah, maybe Greg Cline, Secretary of the Rankin's case, enjoy it. I think this all points to the need of actually doing stuff. I mean, we can all get up there and suppose and say, well, this stream goes in here, oh, it's taking much sediment from the urban rebuttal. But no one does. We need to have a study done. Schnabel needs some basic cooperation to continue to do this stuff. We feel very strongly since all this property is in the watershed, it's going to dump sediment into our upper lake that we just cleaned or we're getting ready to clean. So, yes, it will do it. We feel very confident it will do it. We want to know the extent to which that will occur, and we need a study to do that. And this has all been done too quickly from our viewpoint, and this needs to be researched. No one can say how much it is. We've gotten, and they have been forthcoming, developers have been forthcoming some information, but they don't know. We need to have a study. Champions Run, the county has brought in Schnabel to do a study for Champions Run. This could easily be rolled up. Really, all three properties need to be under the same type of study. They're all interrelated. In fact, part of the dam in Champions Run is owned, is on the property of ZA3667. So it just makes a lot of sense to do the study, find out what's going to happen. On the remediation point, we're asking for future remediation. We're asking for remediation right now. We want it in the zone. But if the developer's going to commit to that, if sediment is being dumped into our lakes, then we have the right to ask for remediation. I think that's only fair. And we've been wrangling this issue for years and spending a significant amount of money to clean it up.
Is it your position that you don't have a remedy for remediation through nuisance or the courts or something else the way anybody else does, apart from whatever the zoning conditions are?
That's an excellent question. Certainly there's remediation from the courts. We've just done that. Our community went through a lawsuit with Wheeling Homes over our lakes and dams. The last thing we want to do is repeat that whole process, quite frankly. And this should be addressed here. I don't see why we're creating problems and not addressing solutions. Just to create another problem that we have to resolve in litigation. And I'm an attorney. The last thing that we need is more work for attorneys. Let's get this taken care of now.
Does that answer your question? Did that answer your question, Mr.
No, but that's
Mr. Hoyt? Do you have a question for Mr. Baker, or are you done?
Yes, I'd like to ask Emory first, and then Mr. Baker.
Yes, sir. No problem.
Maybe you both.
I just wanted to.
I'd like to ask that same question to the two of you.
Okay. What I would like to say is that we have turned over our sedimentation study to Mr. Klein's group. We had a study done there on just the property that we have for you here. And of course, as you know, the county, before it allows any development of that property, is going to determine that the stormwater management plan has been properly prepared and is in place. And there's a lot of interest in this. My client was very interested in it, and for that reason employed their own consultant who's been on the ground and is cooperating with Schnabel Engineering. And
has a report been written yet?
I'm going to let Holt Persinger is the individual who's more familiar with this than I am, and I'd like you to speak to that.
Whole person. And actually, we contracted Contour Environmental to do our state water assessment, and we also hired them to do a sedimentation report to determine how much sedimentation is currently coming into that stream past the property from the Settles Cove subdivision and their two family retention ponds. And as I planned also, once before LDP is issued, to do another sedimentation study to see how much, you know, if you get a baseline of now, before LDP and during construction. So we're documenting sedimentation, and we've already provided them that initial sedimentation study in the meeting we have with Greg Cline and their group several weeks ago.
So sedimentation study, is that getting elevations in the lake, or is that in the stream?
In the stream passing through our property.
Okay.
And you can only look at your property, is that correct?
Correct, as far as that sedimentation goes. I mean, we provided that to them so they can see the current sedimentation in the stream that is going to come through our property, then obviously flow into their property. So in the next several samplings, we'll be able to see how much is already there before we even touch the ground, because the sedimentation is there before we turn any dirt. So.
Did that, do you know if Contour followed up with a jurisdictional determination with the Corps?
We met with Simon Wilkes on site and had a determination, and there everything was, he agreed with what we currently have submitted.
Is that meeting with Simon what Mr. Lipscomb's referencing when he says that the proper person is allowed to determine state waters?
No, I can't remember the exact date, but that was done January, I think.
Mr. Hoyt, you have the same question as Mr. Phillips, is that correct?
Only if there's any additional information on that point.
I've actually had Simon Wilkes out on the property numerous occasions and Jeff Bishop with EPD to evaluate the settlement that's coming down. Now that's being created from the development of Champion's Run upstream. Now, like I had stated earlier, we have a small pond that actually is basically nothing but a retention pond now. And you're welcome to come out and look at it, and you'll see that, you know, it's half full of soot that's coming down. So Grand Cascades is being protected by that pond and the lower lake that's above Grand Cascades. They're both considered retention ponds by the county. They have been out, they have evaluated everything, they have actually done studies on it. Actually, there is a basin study that was done. If you want to contact with county engineering, she can clarify every bit of this. I'm not trying to deny the fact that there is an issue. And with the new development coming in, yes, the water has to be protected. I do not deny that from Grand Cascades whatsoever. However, if their honesty had been from their disclosure of the fact that a lot of their issues on wanting there with them wanting to dredge around the lakes. Okay, there's two lakes that are there. I mean, I've lived there for, you know, gosh, almost 40 years now. So, and my wife and I rode horses all through there. I know those lakes. All they've got to do is step up and say, they have created part of this problem too. It's not the development upstream that has created all of it. When you take a piece of land and you clear it all the way down to a lake, what kind of runoff are you going to get? We all know that. I mean, that's a fact of life. So, you know, I don't disagree with people from Grand Cascades. However, the only difference in this development is they are larger houses. However, they're smaller lots, only based on the fact that there's going to be sewage and not septic tanks. That's it. I wish I could tell you more, but I'm sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Baker.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you satisfied?
Yep, that answers my question.
Okay.
Do you still have questions? Madam Chairman, I may be out of order, I apologize. I've done one of the studies by the engineer.
Madam Chairman,
I'm sorry. Okay. Commissioner Dell,
I just had a quick question for Mr. Cline relative to the assertion that you were offered access to the property but didn't take it. If given access to the property, has Schnabel indicated to you the turnaround time for the sediment study?
Quick punch of the HOA again. We feel they can do it quickly. I mean, they haven't given us the time. But the problem is, it's not just, they will walk, Chuck Wilson and Sean will be able to walk the property. he needs to take soil samples. That's just as critical because, as he explained to me, type of soil, sandy, clay, what have you, that's surrounded, directly affects when the land disturbance happens, directly affects what's going on. I think they can do it in a reasonable time. Did I commit a certain period of time? We certainly would push it to get it done, but we need to have full cooperation on that. And when I went back and I talked a little bit about that, they allowed testing before, I think the gentleman who just testified, they actually came and looked at our records, Grant and Skage records. And we opened our door. Schnabel and ourselves, we let them see everything we've done with the dams and lakes. When we asked for reciprocity to do testing, some basic with a handoff. No, we don't want our land disturbed.
So what you're asking for is, of course, would you drill and actually get soil samples?
Yeah, with a handoff, no power tools. He just, as he walks the property, he just takes soil samples.
We did give them permission to do that, sir.
And y'all did not do it.
Commissioner Rezone, are you satisfied?
Yeah, I'd just like to ask a follow-up question, Mr. Lipscomb. If I'd like to inquire if your client would be willing to allow those studies to be done between now and the Board of Commissioners meeting.
Meeting, I understand the schedule is at 10 o'clock this Thursday morning on that session. So I expect that we'll have some order at that time. What we have been hopeful was knowing that this is a hot issue in this county because most tracts of land in this county have some streams on them. So protection of our streams and against settlement, getting into people's ponds and lakes is a big time issue. And what we had expected was that based on the experience that we're having, we now have all come to understand that the state regulates this very, very tightly, and that we have people here on the staff that will regulate it, and we'll see to it that those regulations are followed, and that you would take action tonight, believing that that would be the case, and that this would pass on to the Board of Commissioners, and that at some point in time that would be resolved with the county and with the state EPD.
So your meeting for Thursday is to determine whether or not they will be allowed to take these?
I would hope that would be the case.
They have an action.
So Contour Environmental and Snobbler set the walk aside Thursday.
And 10. They will be allowed to?
I'm trying to take those up right now. I don't have that information.
Madam Chairman?
Yeah.
The property owner is here. Is that
if the property owner is amenable to that, is that not where you would need to get permission from?
Sure.
Am I confused as to where you received permission
from
to
the
get
landowners?
The state? Is he not here?
He's one of the landowners.
He's not
there are other landowners besides Mr. Pratt.
Sorry.
Okay. So we can say for sure that on his piece of land, we're good. Commissioner Boss, did you have a question?
Yes, I know for a fact that I have seen in another area of the county what I thought was an extremely detailed map, I would say down to almost a square yard, showing every kind of soil that was in that subdivision. And I was led to believe that, although I don't know what department, engineering or perhaps GIS, that we already had maps outlining what the soil types were throughout the county. Now I may have misunderstood what I was told, but I thought that was already the case. Can anybody speak to that?
I know we have generalized information on soil types across the county. How detailed it is as far as site-specific information in terms of current conditions, I would have to check with GIS. I don't know offhand. But we do have a generalized map in the comprehensive plan of the basic soil types.
I need to either come down or respond to a question. Or
I believe the soils that are in GIS are in our CS maps. So it's they look at vegetation and they do a sample of borings and then they figure out indicators, but I'm guessing that they're looking for very specific soil texture to see how cohesive it is.
I think it'd be important to know that one way or another.
I would say, I mean, no matter what type of soils there are upstream, the state has limits on the how much the discharge can have, which is very, very low. So they, you know, if it gets exceeded, then you know there's potential penalties for that. But there is a numeric criteria for how much is exceeding its intermittency.
So, Commissioner Hoyt, this is District 5. Are you prepared to make a motion for a recommendation?
After I ask one more question, if I may.
Okay.
The applicant has submitted a proposed condition 15.
Yes, sir.
Which says the applicant shall continue to work with representatives of the Grand Cascades HOA prior to the Board of Commissioners meeting in order to conduct a site visit of the subject property with the HOA's engineer and the applicant's engineer to identify streams located on the property. Would you have a problem with adding to that and sample soils located on the property so that that gets done before the Board of Commissioners meeting?
I'm not in a position to say that. I think what has caused the problem is there have been a lot of people going on to these landowners' property there without getting permission, even that there wasn't anything wrong with coming on to the property and taking samples and doing whatever they cared to do on the property. And the landowners got fed up with that and they said no more of that. Now we have agreed, and as you've heard, there's going to be a walkover of the property this Thursday. And I would hope that at that time there would be an agreement, but I don't want to tell you something that I don't know the answer to. I would hope that would be the case by Thursday, that they would be able to give that permission as Attorney Cline has suggested for the soil samples to be taken, but I don't have the authority right now to take it. Certainly, we're expecting them to make that walkover. And
hopefully
that will be
a light. Obviously, Mr. Baker has already said that that's acceptable on his property. We just need to get confirmation from Mr. Harris to give the property owner. I'm not comfortable giving that permission to us because we don't own the property owner. So as soon as we can confirm that, we can get that done before the Thursday meeting, but we will want to allow on this portion.
I want to make sure that no one takes what I said, that Mr. Cline or any of his people have come onto the property without permission. They've been very careful to ask for permission. We've had a meeting with the consultants in our office and with Mr. Cline, and all been very satisfactory. So I didn't mean by what I was saying that any of those folks, there have been other people who've gone onto the property without permission, certainly not the Grand Cascades.
Commissioner
Hoyt? Are we getting scroll conditions or am I getting this?
Scroll them.
I move that the Planning Commission recommend to the Board of Commissioners approval of the application ZA3667. Submitted by Ridgeline Land Planning for rezoning of 21.74 acres in Commission District 5 for 32 residential lots with a density of 1.472 units per acre on the property at 945 and 951 Settles Road and 1680 and 1688 Thunder Gulch Pass, Suwanee, Georgia 30024, tax map and parcel numbers 179-041. And 180-026 from the Agricultural District A1 to Single Family Residential District Res 3 as shown on the concept plan dated 5/22/2014, subject to the following conditions. And I think you have the plan if you can skip that on the scroll. And the conditions
that I would include are the engineering condition number one, the water and sewer conditions 1, 2, and 3, the additional zoning conditions requested by the applicant 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, adding to 6 the language stream buffers and stormwater system to be maintained by the HOA. Condition 6, 7, 8, which includes no more than 32 homes, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and there's a second 15, don't ask me why. No permanent access between the subject property and Thunder Gulch Road from the north side of the subject property. And then adding, applicant's latest proposed condition 15.
Would it be 17?
I think it would be at least 17. Yes. Have you got that?
Yes.
And then you have, I believe, those two conditions.
Utility, and right now they're already required to by the engineering standards. They're required to accept those.
So your amendment is just to strike the words stream buffers and storm water system from condition number 5 about homeowners association?
I would accept that.
And the stream buffers portion is just because it's supposed to remain natural, so you really don't.
Commissioner Hoyt, was that a second? Seconded the amendment?
I was accepting that as an amendment or seconding it, whichever is more effective.
Okay. So we have a motion for an amendment. We have a second. Please vote on the amendment.
Before you move, just call for a discussion, please.
I'm sorry. Is there any discussion? There being no discussion, all those in favor of the motion, please, of the amendment, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? The amendment motion passes 5-0. Now we're back to the main motion.
I'd like to make another motion to amend item 9 to read lots shall have not less than 14,000 square feet, with the average lot size being 18,000 square feet. I'd like to state that this would be very compatible on sewer, as we do have a number of developments in the county that have sewer on similar, if not larger, lot sizes.
Second. We have an amendment and we have a second. A motion to amend, we also have a second. Is there any discussion? All those in favor of the amendment, please signify by raising your hand. All those opposed? That motion fails.
Wow.
That motion fails 3-2.
I'd like to make one more motion to amend item 9 to read lots shall not have less than 12,500 square feet, with the average lot size being 18,000 square feet.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second for an amendment. Is there any discussion?
I do a point of discussion. The surrounding lot size, I stated this in our work session, but the surrounding average lot size is 18,625 feet. So I believe that this at the minimum is something that we could do to be in line with the intent of the UDC.
All those in favor of the amendment motion, please signify by raising your hand.
Shall have no less than 12,500 square feet, with the average lot size being 17,000 square feet.
Second.
We have an amendment motion and a second. Any discussion? All those in favor of the motion, amendment motion, please signify by raising your hand. All those opposed?
Wow.
The motion passes 3-2.
You don't even live there. Excuse me, before proceeding, I just want to make sure I heard the announcement correct. What was the vote on that last motion to amend?
The motion was 3-2.
It failed.
It failed. Yes.
Okay. And thank you.
Can we see item number 17, please? I'd like to inquire about the enforceability. I think it's 17. It's wherever we stated that they will do such and such before the BOC meeting, that they will be able to do the soil samples. I guess this is a question for the council, but I don't know that we have the ability to mandate that in their recommendation.
As a practical matter, logically, anything to happen before it's approved is not going to have any impact once it would potentially be approved, or Commissioner Cullen would not adopt something like that at that point in time.
So, Mr. Hoyt, I wonder if we should make a motion to recommend that the BOC require that prior to an LDP as opposed to.
Can you say that last sentence again?
Considering that motion really has no enforcement mechanism, I'm wondering if we should amend that item such as a requirement of the development as opposed to a requirement of development prior to the BOC meeting?
Yeah. If you want to make that motion.
I don't exactly know how it looked before, but I would make a motion to strike the words prior to the Board of Commissioners meeting from item 7.
You're leaving in soil samples, though?
Yes.
I would recommend that you include a time frame. Leaving it open-ended suggests the potential to it being sometime in the future.
I make a motion to strike from item 17 the words prior to the Board of Commissioners meeting and replace it with the verbiage prior to the approval of a land service plan.
Second.
We have a motion and a amended motion on the table, and we have a second. Is there any more discussion about them? All those in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? That motion to amend passes 5-0. Now we're back to the main motion.
I'd like to make an amendment to item 9. Lots shall have not less than 14,500 square feet.
Second.
We have a motion to amend and a second. Is there any discussion? All those in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your hand.
Thank you. He really